Hello to everyone. In this video, I'm gonna explain you how to do a circular convolution cone on a Matlab with or without using standard convolution function. First of all, you need to go to the file new script. Now a new script will be created. CLC, clear all and close all. These are the commands just to clear the command window. Now you will take the input one action and the values in this input signals are 2, 2. We will take a second input signal H. The values inside this input signal H are 1, 1 and -1. Now we will find the length of these signals. L1 is the length of signal X. Length X, here the length L1 is 2. L2 is the length of signal H. Length H, here the length of signal 2 is 3. Now we will find the length of the output signal. In case of circular convolution, the length of the output signal is the maximum of the length of the two input signal. Here X has length of 2, H has length of 3, so the output signal have a length of 3, which is maximum of 2 and 3. So n equal to max L1, L2. Now we will do the cconv to find the circular convolution. X is the input signal 1, H is the second input signal, and N is the length of the output signal. Now we are going to run it. We will see the output on the command window. Here you can see that the output is 040. Now we are going to implement the same without using standard convolution function. In order to do so, we need to use nested loops. Let's have a look at the formula. For circular convolution, we are having the formula xn equal to first signal x1m, second signal x2n-m. The range varies from 0 to n-1. So first of all, we need to zero pad our signal. Make the length of these two signal x and h equal. So we'll zero pad first signal x equal to x zeros 1 comma capital N minus L1. We will zero pad the signal 1. Now the signal will become 2, 2, 0. Similarly, we will zero pad the signal 2 H. H zeros 1 comma N minus L2. Now this is small L1, so we will change it. Now after this, we will do the for loops. For n equal to 1 to n, we are having total of n output sample values, so we will have an outer loop for which will run for n number of times. So first of all, we will initialize the values of output signal as zeros, y equal to zeros 1 comma n. Now we will go for the second inner loop, m equal to 1 to n, because we are having n output samples. Now this for loop work for this formula, m equal to 0 to n minus 1 xm x n minus m. N minus m should be positive, so we will take modulus of this n minus m. Now taking the modulus of this n minus m, We will take a modulus of n minus m and store it in the z. Now we will find the output signal yn. Yn equal to yn plus. We will multiply the two input signal x and h. Xn cross hj. Now this signal will end. Here you can see that we have started the loop from 1 to n. This is because we are having n number of elements, and the matrix and the index of this matrix starts from 1. So for j equal to 0, it won't exist. So we will do j equal to j plus 1, so that we can start from 1 instead of 0. Here you can see that the output is 040. Now we will modify the input signal 1211. 11 minus 1 minus 1. Here you can see the output as minus 1, 1, 1 and minus 1. The output is same using standard function minus 1, 1, 1 and minus 1. Thanks for watching.